Well, if you remember Harold Camping, probably hasn't been in the news much lately since the world has not ended. May 21st, 2011, he predicted the world was in the end. I want to get into how much money these guys make off of this stuff and actually what the kind of problems this caused, besides just being a waste of time putting up a bunch of billboards about this garbage. But I always find it amazing. I don't understand why people follow this stuff. And I'm not like totally anti-religious, but religion is probably one of the biggest snake oil rackets going on the planet. I don't think there's anything more crooked than religion in a lot of cases. In some cases, it's legit, but in a lot of cases, it's not. This guy, you know, he had, basically, what happened is he caused a lot of people to commit suicide too, because they figured the world was going to end, or there was going to be this big problem, and they'd have to suffer through everything. So they might as well die. They didn't believe this guy. It was another one. It was a 27-year-old. Frasno's body was pulled out of the lake just before midnight on Friday. Judgment Day was pegged for the next day based on a prediction from evangelist Harold Camping and his family radio group. And you know, they got him on here. NowTheEndBegins.com. Well, you know what? This is where I see the whole thing is a pile of garbage. If he believes the end of the world is coming, why does he have a net worth of 75 million? The real pragmatic question. Why have a net worth of 75 million? Why are you worried about making so much money? Why are you worried about contributions? Hey, if the world was going to end, I mean, what the hell are you going to do about it anyway, right? So what do you do? Put up a bunch of billboards saying the world's going to end? That's like if you knew a tsunami was coming or something, you're going to put up a billboard, a tsunami is coming. How about just get the hell out of the way, you know? What do you need a stupid billboard for? It's stupid. And I think that's what happened. A lot of people just got out of the way. They committed suicide because they listened to this whack job. Behind thousands of Judgment Day billboards on rural highways and city skylines responsible for a small army of volunteers traipsing across the USA to warn that the world will end on May 21st, 2011. And he's the guy that's behind it, and he made a lot of money. So, another whack job in the works. This is another one too. Another suicide from this time. Fearful teen commits suicide due to Harold Camping's Judgment Day prediction. 14-year-old girl from Russia was so scared of the May 21st doomsday and rapture prediction made by Harold Camping that she committed suicide the same day. Investigators said Wednesday the teenager wants to choose death rather than be among the ones suffering on Earth after rapture. Now, I want to put out something else along these lines, although I think there is going to be an economic collapse at some point in time, maybe problems with the banking system. But you hear all these people all over the internet talking about the end is near, then everything's going to fall apart. Well, in reality, nothing falls apart unless the people actually do real productive work, don't do it anymore. And there's not too many of those around anymore, because I always pointed out that the real economy is based upon the people that actually farm and produce the food, the people that do construction, the people that actually make the wires that have to be strung for electricity, you know, the people that set up the communication networks, the people that weld, the people that repair. These are actually the people that actually make the economy run. There's a lot of fluff in it. There's a lot of bureaucracy. So the world will never come to an end as long as you have people that are actually engaged in actual real production. But I also want to point out that a lot of these things they're talking about, the European situation, the problem with Greece, it's almost like this Harold Camping garbage. People are getting so down in the dumps on stuff. It's a bunch of garbage. And I think it's a game that's being played to keep people extremely fearful. So I want to warn that a lot of the stuff that's going out today with, you know, they're screaming the end is coming, the end is coming. Probably something true about that, because there's some solid facts to back up that there's going to be this economic implosion. But in reality, as long as things are actually produced that people need, and people are actually productive and actually contribute to the production of goods that other people need, nothing's coming to an end, period. It never will. It's actually what goes on in people's minds that actually make it come to an end. And that's what happened with through this prophet here, false prophet, Harold Camping, put it into people's mind that everything was coming to an end, so they took their own life. Now, in a way, a lot of people are doing that today because they're thinking everything's coming to an end. And they have this almost like inner death wish mentality. And I don't buy into a lot of that garbage. I think a lot of people are actually making the situation worse by all the doom and gloom and fear. Now, I could say personally, I got one thing that I probably believe in religious-wise, and that's Fatima, the message from Fatima. And I think there's a lot of garbage probably going on in the Catholic Church. It probably got hijacked a little while ago by some evil people. And the message of Fatima is probably legit. I think that's legit. It makes a lot of sense in some ways because I did some research on that. So I'd say I'm like a little bit religious in some ways. But, you know, we probably are going to come up to some probably pretty bad catastrophic times at one point in time. But the thing is, worrying about it all the time, being in a constant state of fear, it's no good. And, you know, this guy putting up all these billboards that the end is coming, the end is coming, that was bad news. That created the end for a lot of people. And actually, people always putting up stuff about, oh, the financial crisis is coming, the financial crisis is coming, oh, the end is near, the banks are all going to crash. That's not helping anybody either. Because actually, real production of goods and services is really where it's at. Get right down to the basics, get down to the most practical things. You know, what can you actually do that's productive for somebody else that you could sell or whatever like that? The problem is, actually, in our economy, we have a big bureaucracy and a lot of red tape, and we have a lot of productivity that's actually just going into maintaining the bureaucracy. That's our biggest evil that's going on right now. But I don't want people to actually worry too much about, you know, what's going on in Europe as much as they are, because it's almost like this guy, you know, he's screaming about the end of the world, the end of the world, the end of the world. Well, if it comes about, fine, you know, just do your preparations and don't worry about it. That's all I got to say.